A lot of Americans, including myself, are troubled by developments in the Middle East. Syria has witnessed the killing of tens of thousands of people. The president of Egypt is a member of the Muslim Brotherhood. Our ambassador to Libya was assassinated in a terrorist attack. Iran is moving toward nuclear weapons capability. We somehow feel that we're at the mercy of events rather than shaping events. I'm often asked why. What can we do about it to help lead the Middle East to stability and to ease the suffering and the anger and the hate there and the violence? Obviously, religious extremism is certainly part of the problem, but that's not the whole story. The population of the Middle East is very young, as you know, particularly in comparison with the population of the developed nations. And typically, these young people, as the president indicated a moment ago, don't have a lot of job prospects. The levels of youth unemployment across the region are excessive and chronic. And in nations that have undergone a change in leadership recently, young people have greater access to information. In the past, that was being carefully guarded by tyrants and dictators. But now it's available. They see the good as well as the bad in surrounding societies. They can now organize across vast regions, mobilizing populations. Idle, humiliated by poverty, and crushed by government corruption, their frustration and their anger grows. In such a setting, for America to actually change lives, to change communities and nations in the Middle East, foreign aid must also play a role.